I'm Jamin Morrison. I'm a medical oncologist here at MD Anderson Cancer Center at Cooper. And I see patients with gastrointestinal cancers, including pancreatic cancer, which is what we're here to talk about today. The pancreas is an organ that's located deep in the abdomen. It's located kind of in the center of the abdomen, but way at the back of the body. It's one of the reasons that it's a challenge to follow the pancreas and to diagnose any sort of diseases of the pancreas. It functions in our body in two ways. It provides us with what are called enzymes to help us with the process of digesting food. And it's also what I call a hormonal organ that produces hormones that help our body work. The one we know quite a bit about is insulin. Unfortunately, pancreatic cancer is an increasingly common diagnosis. We find it is diagnosed individuals who tend to be older. The average age of diagnosis is in the 60s. We see individuals in their 70s and even 80s. But I would highlight the fact that younger individuals are diagnosed with pancreatic cancer periodically. And it can sometimes be a diagnosis that's missed when an individual presents with symptoms. Speaking of which, I want to highlight the symptoms of pancreatic cancer. They are unfortunately vague and sometimes very indistinct, which again leads sometimes to delays in diagnosis. Patients with pancreatic cancer typically present with fatigue, vague abdominal pain or back pain, weight loss, nausea, poor appetite, and in some individuals, we see jaundice or a yellowing of the skin and the eyes. We tend to diagnose pancreatic cancer first by doing imaging studies, scans such as CAT scan or MRI. But at the end of the day, most individuals are diagnosed with the use of an endoscopic procedure, endoscopy, where we go down the throat and into the stomach, where we're able to get a better picture of the pancreas and usually take a biopsy at that point. Speaking of which, screening for pancreatic cancer is a particular challenge. Unlike cancers of the breast, of the colon, or even of the lung, where we have proven treatment, proven screening tests, there's no generally accepted screening test for pancreatic cancer. Here at MD Anderson Cancer Center at Cooper, we do have a screening program for individuals at particularly high risk for pancreatic cancer. And that includes individuals with known genetic or hereditary changes, or those individuals who have a particularly strong family history where numerous members of the family have been diagnosed with pancreatic cancer. Tune in next time when we'll talk more about pancreatic cancer.